lessons, you don't really get to sit on the same tables as your friends, because, you know, teachers don't want, like, distractions or, like, kids messing around with their mates. But somehow we got put onto the same table. So anyways, everything was going fine, and there was this one guy on there who I did not know, and basically he got put on the table because he was messing around over on the back tables. I'm going to give you a little rundown. So you're the teacher, yes, and this is the back of the classroom, so that you're the front of the classroom, I'm at the back, and then you've got the table here at the side by the door. The door was like, my table was here, the door was there, and I was sitting there, and then at the back here, like this side, was the kid who got moved onto my table, so he could be closer to the teacher, because the teacher was at the front, and she could see what he was doing, because he was always like eating and stupid, you know. So anyways, the guy's over, and straight away, I just know this is not the guy I want to be mates with. It was just really just annoying. Like, he was really an annoying kid, and I know people could be like that when you're young and things. I understood, but I just knew that the kid was just a bit weird. So anyways, I kind of thought nothing of it, but I knew just to kind of stay away from him. I think it was like around 2 weeks went by where we had like quite a decent amount of lessons in with that teacher, and we'd all been like, you know, trying to get to know each other. The lessons were starting to pick up now, we were starting to actually do proper work, because at the start it was just like introductions and things like that of what we're going to be doing. Everything, what I presumed was fine in a way, but it wasn't. So this kid, because apparently he starts to like know me now for some reason, just because, you know, after like the first few weeks of being with people, you start to like let yourself go in a way of like, oh, okay, I've been around this person for a long, like, not a long time, but like a decent amount of time where I can actually like say certain stuff, when that's really not the case. But anyways, I was just talking to my mates on the table, we was getting the work done, things were going smooth, and then out of nowhere, these kids on the table, this other kid that I knew and the guy who had moved, they were friends and they lived close to each other. I don't know how they knew each other, they just did, they just lived close to each other, and I think they went to the same primary school, I'm not too sure, but I know they used to play football and FIFA and just go out together. They start having like a little disagreement and I join in, and the guy for some reason goes to me, I don't know why he goes or even thinks this, he goes, oh, stay out of it, monkey. And I'm like, what did you just say? What, like, what? So the guy who he knew and everyone on the table, like, the teacher couldn't hear because she was like obviously over on her desk this side of the classroom. He kind of said it like a little bit quiet, you know. So he says that to me and I'm like, what? Like, I am really confused of why the guy has said that. Like, you can class it as not racist, but the way he said it and just with the tone of his voice and everything like that, and just saying it to me, I knew he was being racist. So I picked him up on it, and not a lot of people would. Well, depending on the type of person, some people wouldn't pick it up, some people would actually pick it up, but I would want to pick it up, you know. I don't tolerate racism, just no need, waste of time. Like, what is the point? Just give up. Like, please, if you're being racist, just give up. You're just, words can't explain how I feel towards it, just because it's so pointless. I start having a go at the guy, and the teacher tries to like calm me down because she can hear me now, like shouting. I'm like, what the did you just say? I'm like, stand up now, because if a guy's being racist to me or to anyone, I'm gonna intervene. But he was personally saying it to me, so I was like, stand up, because I'm one of them people who don't really care when it comes to things like that. I'm just being open. If someone in the street come up to me and was being racist, depending on how they're saying it and depending on what it's hitting me, or depending on what, say, because a lot of people would actually leave it and be like, oh, he's just saying this. But no, you can't. I don't know, but in this situation I couldn't, because there was people around me, it was embarrassing. It wasn't nice. Like, it kind of hurt my feelings in a way. So I was like to the guy, stand up now. The teacher saw me like shouting, she was like, Izak, what's going on? What's going on? And I was like, no. I stood there and was like, no, stand up now. And the guy was not saying anything. He was like, he was kind of shocked. And I was like, no, get up. And everyone was like, oh, Izak, calm down, calm down. It was just a joke. And I was like, no, this ain't no effing. And then I swore, this ain't no joke. So the teacher was like, Izak, go outside now. So I went outside. I spoke to the teacher. And because it's like a racial issue, she had to call like an SLT, a senior leader, up. And basically they had a word with me. They had a word with a boy. So what happens is, everything gets sorted, as the teachers say. Like, come on, like, I'm not trying to bash any teachers here or anyone in, or just any individual person, but like, teachers don't get the full like description. They don't really know what's going on, like, in a way, because if they didn't hear it, they can't really go off anything. They can just say, oh, it's a he said, she said, or like, he said this. It's just words going back and forth, like, who's lying, who's not, like, you know what I mean? But in my head, I was still kind of like hurt from what the guy had said to me. What actually did end up happening, the guy got like put onto a different table, which was exactly close to the one that we were currently on. I don't know why. Don't ask me, okay? The kid got put onto the table next to where he already was, and I was kind of like, this is a bit strange. So I put my hand up and I was like, miss, could you maybe move him back to the classroom, to like the back of the classroom, sorry? And he started saying stuff now because he knew that I tried to snitch on him, and because like, he wanted to kind of get back to me in a way of like, oh, I'm not standing for this. Like, he was kind of annoyed that I actually called him out upon it. So he starts going to me like, no, like, what the F are you saying? You're swearing a whole bunch, I don't know why. So the teacher was like to him, I nearly said his name, then the teacher was like, get out of the classroom now, get out of the classroom. So the teacher sends the guy out of the classroom. This has all happened, by the way, this is after we basically sorted it, as the teacher said. The SLT comes back up, talks to the guy, he gets a detention, he has to go in and get his planner and write on his planner, etc., things like that. So, you know, I'm sitting there on the table, and he gets sent back in after like 10-15 minutes, and he's just giving me dead eyes, like full on dead eyes. The person who he knew, who I kind of knew as well, but he knew, the person who I know, who was sitting next to me, knew the guy more than me. And he was like, oh, what's going on? And he was just like kind of shocked as well at the same time. And I was like, I don't know, like, can you just tell your mate? I don't want no beef. I just want him to like at least apologize, because I don't want to be getting into no fights. And he was like, okay. So he went over to him when everyone was working, and Miss was like to him, sit down. And he was like, I'm just sorting this. And the teacher knew now that something obviously was going on. So he tried to get the guy to apologise to me. That never happened. He was just like looking over at me, giving me dead eyes, etc., which was kind of weird. So I just took it as like, okay, there's probably going to be something going down after school, even though I don't really want to anymore, because I kind of got to, at the start, I was obviously, I wanted to like at least scare him in a way, but then after that I just didn't see the point of fighting. So you know how schools are, word gets around, and this word got around to the whole entire school. I wish I actually had the video. I did have the video like a year after, and then it was floating around for a bit, but the police got involved, and yeah, people just deleted the video. I had the video, it was back when I had the iPhone 5C, the blue one, and yeah, it was a crazy time. I deleted the video because I got scared that the police were going to find it, and just things like that. So yeah, the video is not available anymore. There is probably someone out there from my school who I haven't saw in years who probably have it, but yeah, just, it's going to be impossible to find them now, just because I don't have Facebook anymore. I don't really get in contact with anyone from my school apart from like one or two people, and that's very rarely. They would come to dinner and I was just standing in the line, just standing waiting to get my dinner, and these two like year 10s, like these older guys, walk up to me, and I was kind of intimidated. So I was like, yo, are you fighting thingy after school? And I was like, what do you mean? And I was like, oh yeah, he said that he wants to fight you. And do you know when racist. It just went down. So he comes to the end of school. I remember trying to avoid the situation as much as possible. Like, I tried to walk around people. I was literally like ducking down behind cars. And I was with a few of my mates. My mates come over to me. Then more mates come over to me. Then I saw the guy who was being racist, and the guy who wanted to fight me, he was literally just like looking at me dead eyes. He had people around him like pushing him on his shoulder, like tapping him like that, going, "Go on, go on, go on." And I was like, "Why is this guy walking the way home that I go?" Because, okay, you've got the school gates, you've got that way which I go home, and you've got that way which the guy goes home. There's only two ways that you can walk home, that way and that way. That way is like to a different side of town, and then that way is towards like my little village thing. So I see the guy walking towards my way, and I'm like, why is this happening? Because there is a park. Literally, you walk out the school, you walk for like not even 60 seconds, you walk down an alley and you're at this park. I've had tons of things happen at this park, fight the whole shebang. Like, I've witnessed my fair share of, you know, teenage things at this park. But anyways, what actually does end up happening is guy, he doesn't come over to me, he stares at me, and I see him walk down the alley the way that I was walking home with my friends. So my friends were like, "Oh, Izak, come on, just walk this way and let's just see what's going on." And I was like, "Okay, let's just see." So you know me, I've got people crowding around me now, like going, "Oh, are you going to fight? You're going to fight?" I've got people over, literally over my shoulders, not giving me no personal space, in my head, saying this, saying that, like, "Fight, fight, fight." I'm like, "No, I don't want to fight." Okay, so I get to the end of the alley. I actually come upon this park where we were supposed to be fighting. And, you know, it's like one of them just normal parks. You've got like a sand pit, you've got one of them zip wires that you sit on like a tyre and you push down. You've got slides, you've got that artificial grass, you know what I mean? Then you've got like a bit of sand next to the artificial grass. So I can see this guy on the park taking his blazer off, and I'm like, "No, this cannot be happening. I'm not fighting the guy." People were going to be, "Oh, you're scared. You kind of started this." And I was like, "No, I called him out for being a racist," which clearly he is a racist. Then when I said that loud, and he heard it, and he was like, "Come on then, come on, do something." And I was like, "Mate, just leave it. Go home, have a cup of tea and biscuits, and chill the F out." And he was like, what you say to me? And I was like, "Bro, chill out, meditate, take a chill pill, just calm down. I'm sorry that I made your bottom hurt, just stop crying." And he was like getting really aggressive now, and I just started laughing. I didn't care, I just laughed in the guy's face, like not exactly in his face, but I was like, like I was laughing up in the air. I was just basically winding him up, why not think I'm like a fighting guy, which I'm really not. But if someone's doing something or saying something to me that's offending me, my family, which I really don't easily get offended, but racism, it's not the fact that the person's being racist to me in general that makes me want to fight or do anything or call them out. It's the mere fact that what's happened in the past with people who've just literally got through slavery and just got hurt through racism. I don't like the backstory and of all that, what happened. So with me, it feels like I have to play my part as like, I can't let this guy who is clearly not my ethnicity being racist to me say this stuff, because when looking back at what's happened to people in the past, like people who've got beaten, people who were slaves, etc., I can't just let that slip, if you'll get what I mean. So I'm like, okay, this is it. People were pushing me to the edge. The guy was pushing me to the edge. So I go and see, I go and investigate what was going on, even though I already knew what was going on. So I walked over to the park, I stood there, arms folded, and I was like, "Yo, what is your problem? Like, first you're being racist, now you want to fight. I know I called you out on it, yeah, because you are a racist." And then I said something which I'm not gonna say, and he was like, what you are? And I was like, "Move away from me now, badge, etc. And in the UK, you have to wear a uniform. So, yeah, if you go into a school, you do something out of school, you've got the uniform on, people can look at that badge and basically refer the badge to the school if they need to contact anyone. They can say, okay, we saw this person with this colour hair, this colour eyes around this age wearing the uniform. You know what I mean? It's just easy to identify people in a way. I'm like, okay, Isaac, calm down, because I was kind of getting angry. So I'm like, the guy, if you're gonna do anything, go ahead and do it. So anyways, the blazer is off, my bag is off, I've literally got a blue shirt on, and I have my, you know, my school trousers and my Air Force, my black Air Force. So I'm standing there, there is people around, it is like a boxing match, the adrenaline's building up, there were so many people, I couldn't just walk off now, because there were that many people there, the whole school would know, schools would know, like, in the area, because it was just a madness. So anyways, I kind of don't remember a lot of it, just because of how much was going on, like, it was intense. So, I'm there, I get into the fighting position, you know, I'm not even going to lie, I get into the fighting position, not portraying, I'm like, oh, I'm a tough guy. In my case, we don't eat in rounds, so you've got round 1 to 3. So anyways, it's not like them American fights, I'm like, you know, you see them American fights and their arms are like, literally just standing there, and we start throwing words at each other. He starts being racist again, which I'm just like, no, cut. He racist again, the fight is happening. So he comes up to me the first time and pushes me back over to like this little railing, probably about, you know, probably no bigger than that, like up to your waist of someone who's around 5'10 to 6 foot. So he pushes me, I go over the railing or whatever backwards, and it wasn't like a hard fall or anything like that, it was just a mere shock of like, yeah, I don't really want to hit the guy first, because this is something that a lot of people don't know, or a lot of people do know. If you're ever in a situation where you're about to fight someone, if you hit that person first or physically touch that person, you're the person who's going to get in trouble, because then that person who you have attacked first, they can then flip it and use it as self-defense. I walk back round after I fell over the fence, and the guy has now like pushed me, he's hit me first, so I'm going to defend, you know. I walk back round, I see him trying to come towards me, and I literally, no word of a lie, this was on record, this guy had it on record, I jumped up, literally, like, I'm gonna say the guy was here, this isn't probably gonna work just because the headphones, but say the guy was there, yeah, I went bang, like, I didn't do it that hard, I've done it a bit lower than that. So now he was dead on the floor, everyone's like shouting, like, I don't know what's going on. I go to the guy, we're just scuffling on the floor and everything, and that's when, like, the older guys break it up, we stand back up, and we literally just start throwing, like, bang, 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 bang. Like, we start, like, throwing, like, punches and everything, blocks, things like that, everything's, like, going crazy. I don't really know what to do, well, I know what to do, but, like, it's the commotion and the crowd, which is really off-putting. That's why I feel like when boxers are fighting, they get put under so much pressure because of how many people are watching. So we start fighting again. And this, again, I did, when he ran at me, I kicked him and he tried to grab my leg. So I got him in a headlock. Like, say he grabbed my leg, I got him, like, round the head in a headlock and, like, flipped over. Not like a front flip or anything, just, like, over his shoulder. And that is when I then stood back up real fast after a little scuffle on the floor and did actually, because he was trying to, like, kick me and everything on the floor, I did actually stamp with my leg, with, my, like, my foot onto his leg, so he could not, like, get back up and carry on hurting me, you know. And that is when the fight was then, like, done, and I actually got told that I was the one who didn't break his leg. crazy. It was all mad. I really can't remember, but yeah, that was the time. Apparently, I broke someone's leg, or people were saying I broke it. People were saying I didn't break it. Then the next morning, after the fight, I did actually like go home. I was with four of my friends. I got home. I told my mom. I'd rather just tell my mom and just tell her so she's not as mad, and just tell her the truth, because my mom, she's like, she'd rather me tell her the truth than lie to her, in a way. And she understands everything. She wasn't going to argue with me. She was like, okay, we'll just see what happens the next morning. So I go back into school, and first thing, everyone is there. They're like, Izak, you're in trouble. And I'm like, well, no, I'm not. It's self-defense. And I was like, they couldn't say anything because they knew it was right. So anyways, I got called into the office. I sat there, folding my arms, and I was like, before I answer any of your questions, can you get my parents in here, my mom, even my dad, someone who's a parent? I'm not answering no questions. And they was like, yeah, that's fine. But at the start, they was kind of like, no, you have to answer these. And I was like, well, I don't. I really don't. Because I was right, they did actually get my parents in. My parents come down at the end of this, when the teacher was speaking to me, came in and whatnot, and they started talking to me, etc., what was going on. Yeah, but then I gave a statement, and then they was talking to my mum and everything about, oh, the guy's in hospital, apparently his parents want to press charges. And my mum was like, oh, okay, is that right? Well, who he'd who first? And I actually told them, I was like, yeah, he was being racist. I told them the whole story. He did actually attack me first, so I used self-defense. And yeah, they talked with the police and everything. That was kind of be like, not when I was there, just, I don't know why the police didn't interview me, just the school did. And yeah, the police actually told the parent that you can't press charges on the guy because your son hit him first. So yeah, sucks to be him, I guess. But anyways, we sorted it all out. The guy did not come back to school for 6 weeks. 6 weeks. He come back, he was a different guy. He was calm. He wasn't as like, I'm not even saying this as like to be funny or anything. He wasn't like he used to be. He was like more, what was the word? He was just a different, changed guy. He actually come up to me a few days after seeing me around, because he kept eyeing me for a bit, looking at me. Then he come up to me when we had a science class, and he was like, oh, I'm sorry for what happened. And I was like, whoa. And I was like, really? And he was like, yeah, I'm sorry for being racist. He did do my leg in real good. And I was like, I don't even know if it was me, mate. But yeah, but I guess the apology is accepted. I shook his hand. We made up with it. And not even gonna lie, I was friends with a guy. I did actually speak to him a lot throughout the school. He got to be one of my good mates. I don't want to say his name just because privacy reasons. We went a lot of places. I used to like go out with him a lot, like with groups of our friends. We used to go out a lot and just chill after that. So yeah, that just shows the moral of today's story is, whatever the situation, good or bad, but mainly bad, because this is a situation where it was mainly bad. If you ever get into a fight with anyone, or anything bad happens, you have an argument with your friends, you can still make up for it. So I hope you take that away. Also, another moral of today's story is, please don't fight. There is no need. I only done it specifically for self-defense, and just to kind of wake the guy up of like, he can't be saying them racist things. Because if you know how life works, in a way, is, you know, some things you've just got to accept happen to you, because everything in life's a lesson. What happens today is a lesson. What happens tomorrow is a lesson. And that's just how you grow and develop as a person. You've just got to learn and just take life each day and just learn from your mistakes. And that's how you become a better person. Because imagine if you never done any mistake in your life, how are you ever going to learn? That's why, yeah, I don't believe in like, oh, this person's bad. No, the person's just done And yeah, that's literally my thought on it. Everyone's opinion's different. If someone thinks something else, you can't change their opinion. So just focus on yourself, I guess. And this is going really deep now. I didn't really want it to go deep, but I guess it was done for a reason. If you enjoyed this video, please do leave a like. If you want more crazy stories, please do let me know in the comments. Subscribe and all bell notifications on. And I'll see you in the next video, guys, for another banger story. Have a fantastic day, night, evening, wherever you are in the world. Share this to some of your like friends who actually like ASMR videos or people who just like ASMR stories. Share this to them. And yeah, I love you all. Thank you for 30 days of subscribers. That is a madness. Oh, I'm still speechless and in just mere shock of weeding 30k so fast. So thank you, you personally, and I love you all. Have a fantastic day, night, evening, and yeah.